नाउ यू आर वर्किंग विद आदित्य रॉय कपूर, थोड़ा सा अपने रोल के बारे में बताओ. एवरीवन वाज महा एक्साइटेड व्हेन यू वर अनाउंस्ड एज द लीडिंग लेडी.
एंड परफॉर्मिंग विद आदि एज हिज लीडिंग लेडी, सो it's a completely different experience. We've been filming now for a long time on Om as well. Is the different I'm getting to explore a completely new world. I'm getting to see myself differently. It's high octane action. It's a thriller. I'm working with some amazing actors who I've looked up to, Jaguda, and you know, so we're having a great time on the film.
Today, if you were to meet Ranbir Kapoor, which is that one question you would want to ask him?
Are we making Rockstar Part 2?
For all film-related interviews, reviews, and content, please like and subscribe to Pooja Talwar. You can also follow me on Twitter and on Instagram.
Lovely to see you, Sanjana. And how beautiful are you looking? Please tell me your whereabouts.
You're so sweet. I'm just right talking to you right in the middle of a day at work, just after lunch break, in the middle of shoot. But the good part is that shoot, you know, things have opened back up. So that's the good takeaway.
And how does it feel to be back on the set?
It feels normal, you know, it feels, yeah, then you realize how things were kind of, how challenging they get. But when you're into the zone, that rust happens for a bit, but then you kind of slide back into it.
But you know, if years later, when you look back at this lockdown, I think you are one of the few people who will look back a little fondly. First film, I mean, as a lead actor, released in the lockdown, did so well. Second film also began in the lockdown. So, you know, and the kind of work you have done. So, I mean...
Yeah, that's the thing that, on, you know, we... I was thinking about it. I was like, to be doing all of this in the midst of what has been such a big catastrophe, it takes extra kind of extra might, and you need to have a lot more kind of energy inside of you. So I think it's been really special that through such tough times, we've been able to manage getting onto sets for another film and shooting that one as well.
Totally. And we'll come back to your movies and your you know, career later. But first, 12th board exams being cancelled, had it happened during your time, well, how would you have felt? Relieved or like, you're a topper. So, aapke liye, I mean, that's why they had memes. How the poor toppers and the, you know, the first ones who come in class would be dealing with the cancellation.
It's unreal that you're asking this, because I can't tell you how many friends have teased me about exactly this, because they were like, you would have planned everything to the T and if the schedule would have changed. But I can't imagine how the kids this time have done it. Like, I know that just when things were normal, how nervous we used to get and how much pressure there used to be to just do well in those exams, you know, because for us kids who have to study in India, your life kind of depends on that aggregate percentage, and it's undue pressure. And then on top of that, you haven't gone to school for the full year. You studied on your own. It's too tough. If I were in that place, I would have had a full meltdown. There wouldn't have been, yeah.
True. And you're also that category, na? Where I used to look at the mark sheet, you know, during my time, like a 70% cutout was, you know, that first division, you've done well. And we managed. Like, I managed to get the college of my choice with 77. Later in the year, 77, kuch nahi milega.
77.
I know, kuch nahi milega. What is your take on the kind of marks? I mean, it's like the Sensex.
It's, Pooja, like, you know, after a point, I remember we used to just be like, listen, jitna pad sakte ho, pad lo. Phir kind of Ram Bharose chhod do, because you can't. It's beyond your hands after a point. Like, the cutoffs go to 99 and 99.5. And even when you get that kind of crazy percentage, like, I did end up, right? Like, I got that 96.5 aggregate. And, but still, I didn't get to choose all my, like, all the courses that I wanted in the top colleges. And, for example, psychology, I got 100 in that in the 12th boards in psych, but I couldn't get psychology at LSR. So just imagine, like, what are you supposed to feel if you kind of max on a subject, but you still can't study it? So that's what, like, so many younger kind of juniors, cousins, whenever they're chatting, like, you want to say so much to them, but there's also nothing to say. It's just how the system kind of is.
Totally. And now you are the ambassador for education, Karimi Education, and doing a lot of humanitarian work. So please tell me about that. I'm very, very impressed.
Thank you.
24 mein toh maine kuch nahi kiya tha itna. I mean, you're an inspiration. We were chakki piecing at work.
Wo chakki piecna bhi saath saath pura ho raha hai. Par isse, you know, honestly, it, I think, whatever you kind of feel really strongly for, you get pivoted towards naturally. Totally. And otherwise, like you're saying, that at a 24 or at 22, where would this idea come into one's mind from to take out time from? Also, our paces of our careers and life are very, very high. So it's not like you can predictably get those 5 hours every 3 days to work on something that you know you want to. You know, your time is not in your hands. But like for me, this started long back when I was in college. So I just promised myself that I want to carry it on. I don't want to stop. I started teaching kids in an NGO when I was in first year. So that was 2014. And it's been like 7 years since. And it was the only thing, I think, that gave me close to as much happiness as being in front of the camera does. Like, there hasn't been a third thing to that. So I'm just kind of holding on to that. And now, luckily, being able to scale it and affect and impact more lives. So
totally. So also during the pandemic, you have been active with Save the Children, the NGO, and the work. What do you now feel? Like, it'll take time for things to settle down. But I know someone like you will continue doing that, because a lot of people said, you know, celebrities kya hota hai, lip service karte hai, jab ho jata hai, but it's an ongoing process. You have to continue doing it. What do you want to see change now happening going forward?
So the biggest thing that's happened is that after the pandemic and its effects socially and economically on specially marginalized families, education has taken the biggest hit. So girls, for example, Pooja, like the real stat is that 10 million girls in India stand at the risk of dropping out of school post the pandemic. And so that's now from COVID relief work, that's what I'm transitioning into, which is ensuring learning continuity. So ensuring that girl, boy, any child doesn't stop going to school after the pandemic, because their parents have been pushed deeper into poverty and education becomes lesser of a priority, because kind of making the girl work so that she can run the house in some way becomes top of mind. So that's what we're focusing on now. And hopefully we're giving ourselves a 100-day target, which is too little, but with everyone's forces coming in, it is possible. So that's what all the energies are going into currently.
So a topper who's been through our education system, a lot of time people say, wish the system is a little more practical. As someone now, as you said, you have cousins, the other generation also, it's going to be tough. Yeah, 12th ka exam, you have college, kaise milega? What is that one change you want to see in our education system that as a youth, as an advocate, as an ambassador, that you would want to appeal ki ye ek change le aao?
For me, it's just... in the way our education is structured, if all the kids who are so brilliant at extracurriculars and sports can on the basis of that get into their dream colleges, and they do. We do have sports quota, of course. We have extracurricular quota. But those seats are very little. They're like about 2 or 3 seats. So if we can increase that, it'll encourage kids to realize that just bookish knowledge or being good in the classroom isn't the only way to be amazing and bright. You can be bright on the field, you can be bright on stage, and that should get you where you want to get to in life, you know? Okay. So even to my principal that at my alma mater, I'm constantly trying to drive this home. So hopefully it'll happen soon.
Well, and we belong to the same school.
Yes. Yes.
I tried to that. Yes. We should do something about that. पर आपको कभी कभी लोगों ने ये नहीं कहा है टॉपर हो फिल्मों में क्यों चली गई कुछ और कर लेती ये मिलता होगा बहुत क्या नहीं
आई थिंक डेफिनेटली मोर देन मी आई थिंक माय पेरेंट्स गेट टू हियर इट मे बी मोर बिकॉज आई एम सो डिफेंसिव और जस्ट सो प्रोटेक्टिव अबाउट हाउ एजुकेशन ओनली हेल्प्स यू एज एन आर्टिस्ट एनीवन हु सेज अदरवाइज इट एवरीवन हैज डिफरेंट पर्सपेक्टिव्स बट फॉर मी It's, I know how it's changed the way I look at the world. And it's made me meet different people who are characters in my head. And so when I read a script, I'm like, at that internship or when I was doing that play, I met this person, either in the audience or my theater coach even. So those experiences only teach you and they make you better at your job. So, it's a misconception, par milta bahut hai. Sometimes you ignore it, sometimes you give an explanation. Because I really want that if anyone's looking to act, they also don't think that it's either acting or studying, you know, just to know that it can be both.
True. Because back in the day, a lot of them dropped out of school and became actors. That thing is there. Padhai nahi hai to actor ban jao, which is not true because it also is a profession. You need to train.
Absolutely. And that's the thing that the thing is that either you're sure from the beginning that you want to be an actor, then you're lucky where you can design your path like that, even go to acting school or go to drama school. I wasn't 100% clear. There used to be fear. There used to be, will it ever be possible? So we also, I think somewhere are just trying to make our option safe. So there's also that. So the people who are clear are also lucky. Then they can,
Totally. And you've also chosen a profession which is not a very easy place to survive. I mean, how do you keep it real? Because I'm sure you also, I mean, I can't handle trolls and negative comments. You youngsters, and especially actors who are there, constantly get the bouquets and the brickbats of things you've done or not done. How do you keep your balance in this industry since you also have been speaking about mental health, which is a huge issue?
I think for someone who, this is also a joke that's running in all, everyone who knows me, that for someone who learns fast, I've been the slowest to learn in this regard. You know, the whole, like everyone who I look up to, who's a mentor, either in entertainment or otherwise, always said that, rhino skin. And somehow, you know, it's easier said than done. So it's developing. I think every couple of weeks, one more layer gets added and you get more and more insulated. And now what I do is that there's just that much time that I'm on social media in a day, like maximum of 20 minutes a day, like throughout the, in total. Because otherwise you can just, it can be a dark hole. And for us, it's work also, kind of work gets mixed into, so for all of us now. So it's really important to measure it and then kind of keep your distance from it.
But Sanjana, does it take its toll? Because a lot of young stars have said, you know, the social media presence, sometimes we wonder our work is only 10%, 90% is to be seen. Your look should be good. Sometimes does it get to you? You're like, you know, mujhe jo main karne hai, wo karne to, why do I have to keep making appearances? But you need to. That's the demand.
But, you know, Pooja, I also wonder, I'm like, if that's there, but it's just one part of it. The core is still the characters you're playing and the stories you're telling. Because if those aren't at the level or are touching people, then all of this doesn't matter. So it's a little bit like chicken and egg. You know, if you just focus on appearances or looking good and being seen, I don't think that on its own can't do anything for you. It's really about the stories you tell. So
I'm sure your friends also ask you, what is it like in the industry? Everybody must be looking up to you. Which is that one myth you want to break, saying jo tumko dikhta hai na wo waisa hai nahi.
There's so many. But I think the one that's top of mind and is true that we know is that the kind of physical, emotional and mental hard work that goes into it. It's almost like manual labor, na? It's like you're on your feet for 16 hours in the heat and it's a lot of real physical work. And it doesn't come easy. That's the biggest myth. You know, nobody lines up outside the door with throwing opportunities your way. You have to find them like everyone does in every industry. So, yeah.
Totally. I get that. So after your debut, lead actor, Dil Bechara, now you are working with Aditya Roy Kapoor. Thoda to apne role ke baare mein batao. Everyone was maha excited when you were announced as the leading lady.
रोल के बारे में मैं कम बता सकती हूँ अभी क्योंकि मुझे प्रोड्यूसर से डांट पड़ जाएगी बट what I can tell you which is exciting me the most and you know we've been filming now for a long time on OM as well is the different I'm getting to explore a completely new world I'm getting to see myself differently It's high octane action. It's a thriller. I'm working with some amazing actors who I've looked up to, Jaguda, and you know. So we're having a great time on the film. So I'm just feeling really, really, yeah. It's been an awesome time.
True, and also other than that, Aditya Roy Kapoor first. Rock star was with Ranbir Kapoor. Aditya Roy Kapoor, you know, they're very high on the female. Most wanted list. So I'm sure you're the envy of most.
Well.
but personally, your take, which one of the Kapoor?
It's, you know, I've met Ranbir and Adi at two such different stages of my life. I'm performing with Adi as his leading lady. So, It's a completely different experience. And for Ranbir was my first window into what an actor is like. He was the first ever actor I did a scene with. So they both hold different and incredibly special places in my life. But what's common in the both of them is just how amazingly chilled out they both are. So they make life very, very easy.
And also as a young actor, is there somebody who you look up to in the industry that you would want to follow that person who inspires you in terms of their craft, their method, their choices of movies?
100%. I think it's sometimes you see a character and you get inspired. Sometimes you get inspired by what they may be doing. For me, I also get really inspired by some of the philanthropic and humanitarian work that they do and you know for me it's also to look up to them because I'm doing it a lot earlier than many of them started so it's a great opportunity to take cues from as well but Vidya for me as an actor has always been my she's almost like my lesson book in performing I love I think just breaking down her characters, whether it's Dirty Picture, Kahani, any of her amazing work. And Anushka just always has been. I've said this before many times. I love what she does with Clean Slate. I love that she's kind of always said what's on her mind. It's, So there's, and Shobana Ma'am's been my ultimate, OG.
Wow. I know a rapid fire to everybody's done it. So like we were just like, I was going through your interviews also. And then somebody asked someone young. They said, no, just ask if she was a journalist. Also as actors, I'm sure you get fed up with questions. Which is that one question she wished that people wouldn't ask her. And this is the question that she would want to ask her contemporary. So I'll start with you. Which is that one question you wish people would stop asking you?
How is it working with XYZ?
Okay, that I'm guilty as. Hiya.
Hinted.
Okay, no more. So what would you want to ask your contemporaries? Let's start with, say, Ananya.
What would I want to ask Ananya? I would love to kind of get ask her how the energy remains up to that degree. I feel like there's this amazing consistency and energy which I find really endearing. So
okay, great. Yeah. If you were to meet Shah Rukh Khan, the one question you would want to ask him?
I would create a cope with Shah Rukh sir to talk about why studying helps you be an actor, because I know he's Hansraj economics and he's very, very nerdy also.
Totally. तुम दोनों की बहुत जमेगी. कार्तिक आर्यन से क्या पूछना चाहोगे?
कार्तिक से I don't know if he's cut his hair already, but I wanted, otherwise I remember there being a phase where I want to ask him, when is he getting a haircut?
Yeah. Priyanka Chopra. Okay.
Oh,
Priyanka
my God. Chopra. Oh, I just finished reading her book. I would kidnap her for a day and just chew her brains on so many things. But just how is she a visionary to the degree that she is? Where does it come from? And just really want to get into her mind.
And today, if you were to meet Ranbir Kapoor, which is that one question you would want to ask him?
Are we making Rockstar Part 2?
Point. What happened to Jordan? Yeah.
What did happen to Jordan?
Interesting. Interesting, yes. And yeah. Manifest. And I'm trying to get... Manifest that. But honestly, looking ahead, what is it that you really want to do? The directors on your wish list, the actors you want to work with, the narratives you want to play?
It's... the last few months have been from the perspective of reading material, make you so excited about the future. Because I remember till even 2 years ago, while auditioning and stuff like that, ek to Pooja, this, I'm still getting used to someone sending you a script. It's still a new tingly experience for me, because I still remember just getting to know very little about a character. And you having to go and audition. You don't know the backstory you created in your own head, you know? So this experience of reading it front to back and someone asking you, what did you think, is still settling in. But the wish list runs so long, and now what's exciting is that there is no barrier. So I know that I can get to work with Gajraj Rao and Jaydeep Alawat, who I adore so much. As much as with an Adi or a Jaguda, and that's just a super exciting place to be. So that's it. I think just wanting to tune into my craft and keep improving at my end, and then leave the rest up to the universe. Just that.
And well, the one change you want to see, because you know, in your time also, it's been exciting. Narratives have changed, stronger roles being written. Lines have blurred, you know. So what is that one change, but going forward, you want to see ki implement ho jaye? There are a lot of good things also happening, but one change as a young actor you really want to see there?
You mean more in terms of the stories we're telling?
The stories you are telling, and generally in the industry, that is the one change you really want to see ki ye implement hona chahiye. Because a lot of people abroad have spoken about there should be more inclusivity, pay parity, all that happens later, but the one change going forward you wish that we really need to focus on in terms of narratives and in terms of the industry?
I think we're already kind in pockets, we're there and stuff, but I there are many actor friends with whom we discuss that I wish we all discussed the craft more. I wish we all discussed stories more amongst each other, you know. And if that could be the focus a little more than even like you were saying pehle of being seen or being all over it, in my head, if it was an ideal world, I would want it to be all about the films we do or the shows and narratives we tell, and less about the rest.
I totally agree with that. So jate jate bata do, agar if you were to, you just finished Priyanka Chopra's book, what would be the title of Sanjana Sanghi's book?
Oh my God. Too soon. Ye 5 saal mein baat karenge.
Chalo, ye 5 saal mein baat karte hain. Totally. एंड हाँ एक फैन ने ये पूछा है आपका टिंडर या डेटिंग ऐप में क्या होगा, वन लाइन टू डिस्क्राइब यू इफ यू वर टू गो ऑन, व्हाट वुड यू, हाउ वुड यू डिस्क्राइब योरसेल्फ?
I find it hard to imagine myself on a dating app.
What but about your generation? You are like synonymous with your generation. You're the second person who can't imagine myself on a dating app.
No, I mean, I would love to be, but we, you, is cheez mein thoda, it could be problematic, na? Like some fake profile, some, sure. Yeah, that could be tough.
Interesting. So there, Sanjana Sanghi also. Set two is ready to take on the world, but ready, she'll be only ready if you are ready. Awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Pooja.
Thank you so much. All the very best. Bye. You too. Bye.
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 If you've liked this interview, please like, share, and subscribe. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram.